Okay, so let us begin. So in the last class, we talked about Horner's algorithm for polynomials, right? N degree polynomials, and where we see that we try to use Horner's algorithm to evaluate the polynomial at some point, right? As well as we try to develop a Taylor's expansion for the polynomial as well, right? So for a polynomial at a certain point, right? So we use Horner's algorithm to achieve both. So now what we are going to do is to, we are going to look at how we can use that version of Horner's algorithm and the polynomial representation of numbers into transforming a number from a given base to another base, right? So that is what we are going to study today, right? So this is base transformation, right, of numbers. So first, let us focus on right? So this is the most simplest case, from any given base into base 10, right? So this is the very simple thing which you have already done at your very low levels, right? So if a number is given on a certain base, then you know how to convert it into a base 10 number, right? So for example, if I say 110111, right, base 2, or let me put one more zero there, 110 base 2, right, so then, you know, 1 into 2 to the power 5 plus 1 into 2 to the power 4 plus 0 into 2 to the power 3, right, plus 1 into 2 squared plus 0 into 2, plus 1 into 2 to the power 1 and 2 to the power 0, right? So you know, this is how you write the polynomial interpolation, right? Sorry, polynomial interpretation of this base 2 number, right? And if you want to convert it into base 10, you just evaluate this polynomial. So 32 plus 16 plus 0 plus 4 plus 0 plus 1. So 21, 53. So this number is 53 in base 10, right? So this example you have seen at even at grade 10 or grade 9, something like that, right? So very low level mathematics, you have seen this transformation. So this is the very basic type of transformation. You convert a base 2 integer into base 10. Similarly, you can convert any base integer, right? So if it is base 4, then you will have 2 to the power 4 to the power 5, 4 to the power 4, and so on, right? So let us say, right, so let us say this is the integer, right? Right, so first thing is, if you write down an integer, right, or any number in any base, right, so here it is base 2 in the example, I put 2. So if it is an arbitrary base, then I put b. So here you have n plus 1 digits, right, a naught, a1, an up to an minus 1 up to an. There are n plus 1 digits in that representation. Like in this example, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 digits are there. Right? So in a base B representation, right, the number of digits we have in that representation is known as the length of the text. Right. So here, text is basically a number. Right. So the length of the text is known as the number of digits in this interpretation. Right. So now you know that. In this example, you know the length is 6. So now what we are going to do is we try to convert this number into base B. So like what we did in example, you just evaluate the polynomial, right? Okay, so so let me name this as X. So that I don't need to rewrite it again, right? Right, so if you want to evaluate this polynomial, right, so if you want to convert this x into a base 10 number, then you basically need to convert it into a base 10 number, so you have to evaluate this polynomial, right? So this is same as evaluating a polynomial at x is equal to b, right? So this is exactly what we did, right? So because I use x there, let me name a different number here, right? So let's say alpha, so that it is easy for you to see that, right? So, right? So because I'm going to, right, so this evaluation is same as evaluating this polynomial p of x at x is equal to alpha, right? Sorry, at x equal to b. Base is b, no? So base is b. So x equal to b. So this is same as evaluating the polynomial at x equal to b. When you put x equal to b, you get this, and that is the base 10 representation of this number. So we already know that we can apply Horner's algorithm to evaluate this, right? Right, so P at B, if you want to evaluate that, last class, we see that we can apply Horner's algorithm. Right, so let us rewrite that Horner's algorithm and see how we can do the evaluation. Right, so what we do is you set new components. Right, so you set AN is equal to K naught, right? So here, right, so then if you evaluate like this, right, like the Horner's algorithm which we studied, right, so if you evaluate according to the Horner's algorithm, then you can see that the remainder kn is considered as the base 10 representation, right? So this is quite simple, so you can always do that, right? So without any trouble, you can always do that. So let me just do one example of how to do this Horner's algorithm thing and evaluation, right? Example 110011 base 2, right? So you want to convert this into a base 10 number. So you know that you start writing from an, right? So it is 110011, right? So these are an minus I, right? So I running from 0 1 2 3 4 5, right? So then you start finding ki's, right? K naught is an, so you bring this without any change, so 1, and then k1 is b, b is 2 here, right? Base is 2, so b times ki minus 1, the previous one, so multiply this by 2 and add with this, right? So this is what you do, you multiply this with 2 and add here, right? So when you add, you get 3. Same argument, you multiply this with 2 and add with 0, So you get 6. Similarly, multiply by with 2, add here, so you get 12. Again, multiply by 2 and add here, so 25. Right? And then same argument, multiply 25 by 2, add with 1, so you get 51. Right? So you multiply this by 2 and add here, so you get 51. Right? So you can see that. You can either directly evaluate the polynomial, right? Or you can use Horner's algorithm to transform a number from a given base B into another base 10, right? So this transformation is about transforming from one base into base 10, right? Not some other base. Into base 10, right? So this process will work. So you can apply Horner's algorithm, right? So let's say for another exercise as a homework. So if you have a base 4 number like this, right? So you can try to convert this number into base 10, right? Another one. If you have a base 8 number like this, you can convert this into a base 10 number again, right? So you can see that because this is base 4, I have all the digits between 0 and 3. Here, because this is base 8, I have all the digits between 0 and 7, right? So that is how you write base 8 number and base 4 number. And now you know the algorithm and you know the procedure. So you can convert it back to the base 10 number, right? Right. Now, what will happen, how you can do the reverse? Right, so now what we are going to do is we are going to see how we can convert a base 10 fraction into base B base 10 integer into base B integer, right? Right, so now let us see how you can do this transformation from base 10 to base B, right? So let me give you the same example which you learn in O levels, right? Say you have 35, right? And you want to convert it. 35 is a base 10 number, right? You want to convert it into base 2. So what you did this, right? 35 into base 2, you want to convert it to base 2, right? So in O level, what they teach you is this. You divide 35 by 2, right? 17, and you put the remainder there, right? 1. And then you divide by 2, 8 and 1. Right? And then you divide by 2, 4, 0. Okay? You divide by 2, 2 and 0. You divide by 2, 1 and 0. Right? So this is how you divide, this is how you transform the number from base 10 to base 2. Right? So what you do is you divide by 2 and put the remainder on the side. And then what you do, you start writing from below, right? So then this is equal to 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, base 2, right? So this is how you write, right? 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. That is how you write 32, right? In O level, this is what you study. So exactly this is what we are going to learn as an algorithm as well, right? So what you do is you take the number, right? So you are going, actually what you are going to do is to, in this algorithm, you have to go backwards, right? So you have to go backwards and you have to find A1, A2, A3 and so on, right? So what you do is, when you look at this, this is what you are doing, right? So you take this number, right? This number, when divided by B, you have a quotient and remainder, right? That remainder is your AN minus I, right? And then again, you take the quotient, divide by base, quotient and remainder, right? So this is exactly what we are going to do as an algorithm also, right? Okay, so given, right, so given a base 10 number alpha, right, so you want to convert it to, right, so you want to convert it into base 2, base B, right? Right, so in order to apply Horner's algorithm, right, so originally Horner's algorithm is developed to convert base B into base 10. So now you are going in the reverse way. So you have to apply the Horner's algorithm in the reverse way, right? So that is exactly what you did in the here, right? So that is what we are going to write it down as an algorithm here. So what you do is you start from the last step. You set Kn as alpha, right? And then what you do is this. Right? So because you are going from bottom to top, you start with this, right? So you start with k n is equal to alpha, and then what you do is you take that alpha, divide by b, you will get a quotient and a remainder. Name the remainder as a n minus I, right? And then continue, right? So the quotient you have, take the quotient, divide it by b, and write the remainder as a n minus next. And then again, take the quotient, divide by b, right? So if you continue doing this, you will continue until you get a zero quotient, right? Right, so what you do is you stop when the quotient is zero, right? So here you see that in O level they ask you to stop here because you know you cannot divide 1/2, right? So if in case if you divide this by 2, you will get a quotient 0 and remainder 1, right? So that is the actual division procedure. So in that case, what you do is you don't come all the way here, you start from here and write down everything here, right, all the way on backwards. So that is what we are doing, right? You can see that we are naming backwards, right? A n minus I, a n minus, also a n minus n, so that is zero. So a naught, a one, a two, up to a n, that is what we are doing, right? So then right, so then clearly alpha, the base B representation of alpha is written as an, an minus 1, an minus 2, all the way up to a naught, right? So that is how you start doing this, right? So let me give you an example. How in a table form you do this. Right, so you want to convert this into a base 2 number, 19 into a base 2 number, right? So what you do is you set ki an minus I, right? So you set kn is equal to 19, right? And then what you do is you divide this by 2, right? So when you divide this by 2, right, the quotient is, when you divide by 2, the quotient is this, right? So 9, and then you put the remainder here, right? So you know that when you divide by 2, this and remainder here. Remainder is this, right? So when you divide this number by 2, 19 divided by 2 is 9 and 1 remainder, right? 9 into 2, 18, 1 is remainder. So that is how you do, right? And then next step, again divide. So 4 and 1, right? So again you divide 2, 0, 1, 0, right? So when you divide by 2, you get 1 and 0. You know that you continue the algorithm until you get a quotient 0. So you have to go one more step, right? So you divide this by 2, so you get 0 and 1. So when you get 0 here in the quotient, you stop. Right? So when you see a 0 in the quotient KI line, you stop the argument. Right? So you can stop the argument. Right? So once you stop the argument, what you do is you start writing the number in the reverse order. So you write this in the reverse order. So 19 is basically equal to, you start writing from there, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, base 2. Okay, so that is how you write down the number in base 2. Right, so this is an example of converting a number into base 2, right? So I will give you two more exercises to work on. And so you can try these two exercises in the same way, right? So if you put that in the table, you can do everything in one step. So you do that in a way, right? So now we talk about integer numbers, but you know that there are other types of numbers as well, right? So 1/2 is also a number. 1/3 is a number. 2/5 is a number, right? 300/4565 is a number. They are fractions, right? So those numbers are fractions. This one, so far what we talk is integers. 19, 1,999, 35, 5,455, all of them are integers. But we don't talk about 0.1245 or 0.1321475. These kind of numbers we did not talk about so far, right? But those are also numbers. So we have to see how we can convert those numbers into a base B and also vice versa, right? So if you have a fraction, how do you convert a fraction from base B to base 10 or base 10 to some other base B, right? So we will see how we can do the transformation in fraction, right? Okay, first thing, first we will talk about how to transform fractions from base B to base 10, right? Before going into the transformation, let me show you how you write the polynomial interpretation of a fraction, right? So I'll start with the base 10 example. So this is a fraction, 0.1234 in base 10. Right, so it is a fraction. So you have to write down first the polynomial interpolation of this, right? So how do you write? Right. So this is basically, you can see that Okay. So 1.1234 is actually this. Right, so let me show you clearly. And so this is 0.1 plus 0.02 plus 0.003 plus 0.0004. Right, correct? This is how you write the fraction. 0.1234 is 0.1 plus 0.02 plus 0.003 plus 0.004. So this is basically 1 times 10 to the power minus 1. So 1 upon 100. This is 1 upon 10. This is 2 upon 100. So 2 upon 10 to the power minus 2 plus 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 plus 4 into 10 to the power minus 4. Right? So now you see that you have a polynomial representation with negative powers, right? So you have a polynomial representation, but with negative powers, right? So okay, so a polynomial representation for a fraction. So because it is a fraction, I denote the coefficients of these polynomials with minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, right? So that you know it is associated with b to the power minus 1, a minus 2 is associated with b to the power minus 2, and so on, right? Just for the sake of understanding, I use this notation, right? But you can use a1b, a2, a3, so on as well, right? So it doesn't matter. But just to give you an understanding, I write it down in this form, right? So this is the polynomial representation, right? So now, similarly, if you want to convert a base 2 fraction, so another example, so now you know 0.1011 base 2 is a base 2 fraction, right? 0.1011 is a base 2 fraction. So you can, if you want to convert it to base 10, right? So you write this as 1 times 2 to the power minus 1 plus 0 times 2 to the power minus 2 plus 1 times 2 to the power minus 3 plus 1 times 2 to the power minus 4, right? So that is 1 upon 2 plus this is 0 plus 1 upon 8 plus 1 upon 16, right? So this is 16 over 8 plus 2 plus 1, that is 11 over 16. Right, so 11 over 16, you can write it down as a decimal as well, right? So if you divide 11 by 16, you can see what is this number, right? And you can use a calculator to see that, right? 11 over 16, Right, so that should be 0.6 something like that. I don't remember. Maybe it is 110. So 6 is 96. 96 and 414. 140. So 7. Maybe 675 or something. I don't remember, right? So to check this, and you can see that, right? Or 675 or 6825 or something like that, right? So you can double check this, right? So 1.6 and the rest you can see, right? Right. So these are, so those numbers you can see by using a calculator. So this is how you transform base 2 fraction into base 10, right? So when you have the polynomial representation, you can directly evaluate the polynomial and calculate it, right? But we already know some algorithm called Horner's algorithm. So we shall see how we can apply the Horner's algorithm to convert a base B fraction into base 10 fraction. Right, so then when you calculate this, right, so you started calculating from last digit, that is a minus n, right? So you might that set that as k naught, and then k1 is b inverse times k naught, right, plus the next digit, right? So you can see that you go all the way up to n. So, but when you put n, you have kn is equal to b inverse times kn minus 1. That is fine. Right? But here you can see that a 0, a of negative 0, or that is 0, right? Which you don't have, right? In this polynomial representation, there is no a naught, right? So because we consider this as a strict fraction, we always set a naught as 0, right? So this term is considered as a naught, right? So here, right, so a, when the case where you have a minus n, that is a naught, you set that equal to 0. Right, so that is how you do that. So let's see an example of how you do this in table, right? Okay, so let's say we have this number 0.0101, right? Base 2, right? Base 2. And you want to convert it to base 10. Right? So what you do is, you start writing the numbers, right? Digits in the reverse order. Right? Because you say, you see that? You started with A minus N, right? So you write the numbers in the reverse order. And recall that. Right, so you start writing the numbers in the reverse order, because if you look at the algorithm, you start from the last digit, right? So you start writing the digits in the reverse order, right? So 1 0 1 0, those are your digits, but you recall that you always set A naught as 0, so the last component will be A naught, and that is 0, right? So here what you do is, you said k naught is equal to, right? So ki, so k naught is equal to this. Without any change, you bring this down, right? Next, what you do, you multiply that by 1 upon b plus the next a, right? So you multiply this by 1 upon 2 and add. So you have a 1 upon 2, right? According to the algorithm, you multiply the previous k by 1 upon 2 and add the present a, right? So you multiply the previous by 1 upon 2 and add the present a. So you continue doing this. Multiply by 1 upon 2 and add. So 1 fourth plus 1, right? So that is 5 fourths. Again, you multiply by 1 upon 2 and add. So you get 5 eighths. Again, you multiply by 1 upon 2 and you add. So you get 5 over 16. Right? So that is your base 10 representation. Right? So 0.0101 in base 2 is equal to 5 over 16, or you can say that it is 3125. Right? So this is how you convert a base B fraction into a base 10 fraction. Right? So next class, we will talk about how we can convert a base 10 fraction into a base B fraction. Right? So after that, we will talk a little bit more about other types of number representations in numerical computing based on computer arithmetic, right? So I will stop here, and then I will continue with the other transformation from base 10 to base B fraction in the next class.